guys, welcome back to the Boss Courtside YouTube channel. As always, I'm Nanai.
I'm Kayla.
And today we have a special guest. Please introduce yourself.
Yes, I'm Ben Zulsdorf from Rincota Church, the high school director. My last name sounds like a cartoon character or something from Harry Potter. It's cool.
Not a big deal. Yeah. Just in case you guys forgot, what camp was it?
Middle school retreat?
It was, yeah.
The middle school retreat, winter camp, yeah.
When we were all on stage singing...
Intentional.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's a good time.
Travis Green.
Yeah. Got to see some dance moves. Got to see some singing.
A lot of crowd interaction.
A lot of
arms swinging.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Dancing. Mm-hmm. It was fun.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. All right.
It's the most soulful we got for sure.
It definitely was. But you know,
it was fun.
Good.
Yeah.
It was good. It was nice to include it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So. Since you do music,
yeah,
you lead worship at your church sometimes.
Yes,
I do high school ministry.
I do, yes.
Do you lead a band with high school?
Yeah, we have a student band, a handful of students that rotate throughout, so super
That's pretty
fun.
Cool.
Yeah.
So we're trusting your musical opinions. We're going to play a game.
Wow.
We're calling it Bop or Flop, and I'm going to play a few Christmas tunes, and then you two have to decide. You can just listen to like 10 seconds of it.
Uh-huh.
If it's a bop. Or if it's a flop.
Yeah.
It should be easy.
Yeah.
All right.
I got great opinions about these sorts of things.
All right.
Good time.
Are you ready?
Yep.
I really can't stay. But baby, it's cold outside. Okay. I've got to go away. But baby, it's cold outside. All right.
That's a bop.
It's a bop?
That's a bop.
All right. Here's my perspective. Movie Elf, that's like one of the best scenes in that movie, if you guys are Elf fans, okay? However, there's been a lot of controversy about the lyrical content of that song, and so I'm going to go melodically bop for sure. Content-wise, it can be a flop.
It can be a flop.
A lot of people are talking about how that song has perpetuated, like, date rape, which is definitely not a bop for Christmas. I'm not sure if I can go there fully because the song is really old.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm halfway. You know what I'm saying?
All right. I'm hearing is flop. I think I answered a flop. Sorry about that, folks.
But a lot of people go there.
Some people like it.
Some people like it.
And some people do not.
Not
some
anymore.
Like it, yeah.
Yes.
That's a pretty controversial thing, though, right?
Controversial Christmas music. That's what
it's
I'm here
for.
All
thing.
Right.
Wow, we went deep.
I would have never.
We went real deep, real quick there. That was crazy. Oh.
I'm just scared to say bop at this point.
I know. No. This is a good one. This is for sure a bop. Like 100% a bop. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. The very next day, you gave it away. It's a bop. Have you heard that song? Familiar with that song? Are you familiar with that one?
I mean, it's cool. It's not, you know, really down my lane or whatever,
flop
but
flop.
I'm a flop it. Sorry.
All right.
Oh, sick. Wow. Oh. Mama's kissing Santa Claus. Can we keep going there? I need a little more. Can't make an accurate assessment.
Bop.
Bop.
Automatic bop.
Yeah, I'll go with that.
Yep.
It's a bop.
Okay.
Yeah. Bop for sure.
Bop.
Come on. We gotta limit a little more of that one, because I just.
It is. Maybe we'll put it in the credits.
Oh, okay. All right.
Newer. It's the most
beautiful time of the year. Bop for sure.
Bop.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
I think it's a bop.
Yeah. Here's another new one. Ready?
I think it's a bop. So can I just say something real quick? There's this TikTok sound that uses the instrumental, And I thought that that's what you were playing.
Oh, no.
And I was going to get really offended if you played that on the Ministry Youth channel. But yeah, that's a bop for sure. That's a bop. You just really confused me at first.
I'm kind of split on that one, to be honest. I think it's... Nah, I'll go with bop.
All right.
Yeah,
okay.
You can get the bop. Ooh. Bop for sure.
That's the best song to Christmas Carol.
Oh yeah.
There's lots of energy. Mm-hmm. Let's see.
What else you got for us? Mm-hmm. So excited. I just love Christmas music.
Me too.
I love this music.
It's quite the intro.
It's old school.
It is.
We love the old school though.
Dreaming for sure.
Yes, bop.
Just let the bop. Ones I used to know.
Bop.
You're a mean one.
Bop. We just did the Grinch run.
But does it make it a bop? Like, yes. Do you
I'm gonna disagree.
I will.
I'm gonna disagree with the bop factor. I'm gonna go a flop for that category, but it's a great Christmas tune. I just can't, you know.
I would have said flop if we didn't do the Grinch Run Challenge, but because we did the Grinch Run Challenge, it's a bop.
Yeah.
Okay. How about?
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Okay, that version, flop. But the rest of the songs, but any other version of that song is totally a bop.
Yeah.
I got some great versions of that song that we do for, a little more like 20. Even 2010s, you know what I'm saying?
Okay,
yeah, that version was a flaw.
Yeah.
How about this one?
For sure.
Yes. On the first day of Christmas. Okay.
That's a flop. Lose me after the first one.
Okay. So there's a version of this that one of my favorite bands, Reliant K, does, and it is the greatest Christmas song of all time.
I might need to listen to that.
Christmas. It's like 3-minute song, goes quickly.
Oh, 3 minutes?
It vibes.
I feel like that song is not always the best to listen to, but it's sometimes kind of fun in a group when you each like have a different day that you're supposed to like.
That pacing is like, wow, we're going to be for a long time.
Yes. That's why I said flop.
It's like a 7-minute
off the bat.
Yeah. Okay.
Bop. It's not even a question. Bop for sure.
Bop.
All right, last one.
Happy holiday. Bop.
Bop. Bop.
JT at his finest. And sing.
Uh-huh. All waiting for some like Chris Brown's version of This Christmas, maybe.
You would have definitely got that about Chris Brown on this show.
You're right. Yeah, not Chris Brown.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Right. Yes, the Chris Brown version, but.
Well, there we have it. Bop or flop. Seems like you guys think that all Christmas songs are good.
Most of them. Most of them are bops. Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
Well, thank
good
you.
Stuff.
Yeah, you can let us know in the comments. You can let us know on Instagram what your favorite Christmas song is. If you thought any of those were flops, where they were like, it's a bop.
I have a question. Can I ask a question?
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like this is just goes with Christmas music in general? Is it appropriate to listen to Christmas music before Thanksgiving or after Thanksgiving?
Ooh, after.
After?
After.
Why is that?
I mean, that just goes with putting your tree up right after. So
this is true. Okay.
The anticipation. We've always been after Thanksgiving people in my family, but this year I felt a little different because I've just been wanting something joyful.
It's because you've been locked up.
I know.
Yeah. Oh man.
Yeah, I know.
There goes the bow.
There goes the bow. Well, you know, it lasted for a while. Target's finest Christmas decorations. But I wanted something happy, so Christmas music came a little bit early this year.
Nice.
Also, there are no, like, Thanksgiving bops. It's not like that holiday has any music.
There is a new Thanksgiving bop I'll show you. Have you heard of Ben Rector?
Yeah.
Okay, he just released a Thanksgiving bop.
What's it about?
Thanksgiving.
Being
grateful. Gratitude.
Being colonizers.
Not about, like... Genocide, Native American genocide. Like,
they colonizers. Hey.
Yeah. This is our colonizer song. Yeah,
but he does. His version is more like. His version is more like pumpkin pie, not the genocide side of things.
Okay.
That's better.
Yeah, okay. Talking about like there's been through a hard year.
There's a lot of things to be thankful for.
I thought it was good. If there's gonna be a Thanksgiving bop. That's it.
Okay good. Yeah. We'll as long as it's not, you know.
He's not celebrating that.
About what actually happened.
Yeah.
Then, you know. We're good.
We'll put it up on the story. You guys can listen to it and give us your thoughts.
Yeah.
I'm sure you have thoughts.
Yes. I was going to say my answer to that question. My wife starts listening to Christmas music like in July. So it's just.
Dang. Yeah. July.
You know, that doesn't really surprise
doesn't,
me.
Yeah. It doesn't like. She won't be like consistent, but she'll be like, I need some Christmas music. And she'll be like, Christmas in July. Let's do this. And then we'll have like a day.
That's crazy.
And I'm cool with it.
Yeah. That's mad That's early.
Cool. Yeah. Pretty early. But I'm around the like, after Halloween is my like, I get the
Christmas. I think that's Christmas. That's ideal.
Yeah. And I think a lot of people are like that. I mean, the stores start doing Christmas in like September. Yep. So.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah.
Christmas music, it's about.
Almost cool.
Get with it or get lost.
Yeah.
Almost all of it. Yeah. Dang. The Jonas Brothers have a Christmas song. I should have played that one.
Come on. Like, you know how
what
we
I
are.
Thinking? I know. Yeah, all of our car rides are like gospel and Joe Bros.
Yeah, I like to throw a little bit of Jonas Brothers in there, a little love bug every now and then.
Yeah.
Year 3000,
That's
maybe.
That's the one. Nice. Yeah. All right,
interview time.
All right.
So, Ben Z.
Yep.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yes, I'm from Colorado originally. Lived out here for 3.5 years now. My wife and I do ministry together. We're in Covenant Church. She's a middle school pastor, a high school
Shout
pastor.
Out to the church.
We're in Covenant Church. Yep. We're in Covenant. Kayla was there.
I was.
She was there, yeah, before we were there.
Before you were there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep, and I'm glad that we're friends, because when we came there, I was like, oh man, hopefully she doesn't hate us, but it's cool. She doesn't hate us.
Nope, we're good. No, this is actually a roast. Let me tell you all the things.
Wow. So we've been there for 3.5 years, and it's good stuff. I'm worship leader. And I like to snowboard, to play music, play drums, guitar, I sing.
He does it all, folks. Mm-hmm.
I'm a jack of all trades, master of none. It's all media. Mediocre is all get out. Right in the middle. You're like, that's not bad. All right. We'll include him. That's like the role I play.
Perfect.
So
we all need that person.
Yeah. How'd you get into worship?
So I started playing guitar when I was 13, and I got involved with my youth band when I was in youth group in high school. And then when I went to college, I got involved playing in a ministry called Crew with some of the best musicians that I had known. And they kind of took me under their wing and became a thing that I was doing. At the time, I was snowboarding a lot, and I wanted to like graduate college early and go move to the mountains and snowboard a ton. And then I started doing like tons of worship stuff, and I fell in love with playing music and growing, and it was super fun. So, yeah. So I feel like the Lord like just opened up some doors and stepped into them, and yeah, so I started.
Have you Pretty been, cool. or since you started, have you been able to, I don't know, open some doors up for other youth or other people too?
Yeah. So when I was in Kansas City, I'd like to say yes to that question. I think I have. In Kansas City, I was, my first job in ministry was in Kansas City after I graduated college. And I was kind of like a youth worship pastor. Mm-hmm. And a lot of those students went on when they were in college to like do some worship stuff that was kind of influential throughout their campuses and stuff like that. And so I feel like I've been able to like pour out in worship leaders and have them have that a part of what they do, which is cool.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's I love that. That's like, if I can do that, that's like my favorite thing, is getting able to do that kind of stuff.
So what's some of your favorite worship songs?
Okay, so I
right, about to get into it.
Stereotypically fall in a lot to like the Hillsong Bethel category. But here's the reasoning that I like a lot of what they do. Their drums always sound really tight and punchy and fat, and then their guitar parts are really exceptionally ambient and delicious and tasteful. So I like as far as like the main stuff goes, I like those two. I think Maverick City, what they're doing is so amazing. So I love them. I really enjoy Elevation Worship, what they have to offer. And then there's like some smaller, like unknown artists, like indie kind of peeps that have done worship stuff. There's a guy named Aaron Strumpel, who's from Colorado. He's done some cool some cool renditions of stuff, some cool hymns. There's a band called Ascend of the Hill, which is like a little more like, let's go. And they've released a really cool record years ago. But yeah, anything that kind of like blends the like, so a lot of like worship music takes like YouTube vibes, like that band, and like blend, like it's kind of like, it's like a modern rock kind of feel. Mm-hmm. I like that kind of stuff.
So. Honestly, me too. Anything that has a good, any good drum patterns or guitar in general, you have my attention fully.
Totally. Yeah. And so, but then like I'm learning to like, when we did the Travis Green thing, that was super tight. I'd love to grow in like my appreciation for more gospel influence and style. And
you came to the right place.
So I know. That's cool.
You came to the right place, my friend.
Well, so my first Sunday here, I wasn't like on staff yet. I was just coming out to check out the church. Pastor D invited me, and the worship was like all Hillsong. It was all songs like that because it was a guest worship pastor, and I had no idea that it wasn't like how the worship actually is here.
Totally.
And then I came back like the next Sunday and was like, oh, this is a totally different game.
Yeah.
When it was actually Kevin up there leading worship. Yeah. And then it was like, oh no, like this is how this church gets down. It's not,
that's cool.
Not the Hillsong, but definitely appreciation for it.
We're trying to like, we're in Covenant is trying to become more, like we're trying to have a bigger multicultural reach. And so I'm like, I love like that conversation and wanting to grow in that kind of way. I think the church is best when it happens. And so, yeah. But yeah, my influencers are mostly like, the white people stuff.
Yeah, well, we know what we know, right? Yeah. So we learn something else. So.
Yeah. So yeah. That's why, yeah. But have a big love for that and heart for that. So, yeah.
So what songs really get you moving? Like, I know there's songs that, you know, make you really emotional, but then what songs
get you stoked?
Yeah.
So right now there's a song called Promises by Maverick City that love that song. It's talking about like God's faithfulness and like declaring that. I think like those songs right now in this season, like those get my heart stirred up. I just feel like anything that talks about hope and like amongst the struggle, I think like there's a resonance to that right now. So that's the song right now that gets me going. There's an old Hillsong song that like they just kind of released, and it's called oh my gosh, what is it called? Give me just a second here. Fire Fall Down. It was off a record they did in like 2005, but they've since released it. And I was just like walking the other day and it came on. I was like, this is so good. but like also like the guitar hook on that is super sick. The drums are fat and they just usually enters into my soul.
Yeah.
Tugs on the strings. So that's a song that I've been stoked on too. There's a guy named Brandon Lake. Who he's with Bethel, but he also does stuff with Mav City. He's kind of got like a gospel feel to him. He's released some songs I really like, and that we do super good. So yeah, that's kind of the bops right now.
The bops.
Worship bops.
Like it. Okay, last one.
Yeah.
So oftentimes.
Yeah.
When I'm in public, more so when school was a thing.
Okay.
I would be listening to worship music, and I would catch myself either completely like full out dancing. I'm like, look, you are in a crowd, or not even a crowd, but you're around other people, and you see somebody just busting out dancing, you're gonna be like, okay, I'm gonna just go this way. So it's either I'm busting out dancing like concert style, like at the camps, or I'm like break down crying. Like, have you ever been caught in a moment like that?
Oh, yeah.
In public around other people?
Okay.
I just need to know if I'm
alone?
The only
you're
person
not alone.
Doing this.
Yeah, I mean, I have had moments where, like, I'll have my headphones and I'll be singing along, and my wife will be like, you need to stop singing.
Yeah,
like,
see?
So that'll happen for sure. When I was in college, I had several moments where I'd be, like, walking and just, like, full on, like, oh my God, God is so good. This is amazing. Full on. I'm like a non-shame, like I will cry. Mm-hmm. I'm cool with that. Comfortable in myself to let the tears flow. But yeah, you're not alone in that for sure.
Thank God. Yeah. Cause.
Yes. No, and then like even like with worship music, one of the reasons I do it and why I got involved is because it meant so much to me in my walk with the Lord, and like and how I met Jesus was very real for me and that kind of stuff. So yeah, for sure. I still get the feels.
Yes.
In public.
In
the public.
Public
feels. That sounds really awful. I still get.
You still get the public feels.
If COVID you know, you version, know.
Yeah. Social distance style?
Yeah. Social distance style, mask style.
Yeah. But yeah, I do. It does. It influences my mood. So, oh yeah, I'll get after it for sure. You're not alone, Nanai. You're not alone. Thank God.
Well, we asked this question. We had one of the people on our worship team come on the channel a long time ago, and we asked her, if you were to give advice to any of our students or to anybody watching who maybe they feel like they connect with the Lord most through worship, or they want to get into what it is to lead worship in a musical way, what advice would you give?
Yes. So I think that anyone who's interested in leading worship, being a part of it, there's like a few things that I tell my students. And the first one is that worship is a choice. And so over the long haul, even as a musician in general, like there's gonna be times when you feel passionate and times when you don't. But the beauty of what worship is like it's always declaring God's goodness over our emotions and our feelings. And so I always talk about that. Like if you start there, like worship is a choice and God is always worthy. Start there with your heart posture and attitude so that if you're in front of people, you're always choosing God no matter how you feel about it. Mm-hmm. As far as like the next step, this is I think there's like these steps before the musicality of it. I think like the best worship leaders are the ones who like lead worship best without any music off the stage, like with your life. And so worship is like a way of being and carrying yourself. So if you're not like if you want to be a worship leader, then like you got to be the first to like work on forgiving people well and being merciful and working on your own character and seeking the Lord and being the first to serve. Like if you're not doing those things, then when you're on stage and people see that position, if it's the opposite, then there's a disconnect there. So I think that worship leading requires like you have to live that out all the time off the stage. And then I think as far as musically goes, like just get involved, like playing and doing it and surround yourself with people who are better than you and take like, be receptive to like input and advice and to grow and be hungry to learn. So those are kind of the main things.
And Party Pat was on here a few weeks ago and he offered to teach people how to play guitar. So if you maybe can sing, we have so many people in our group who have like fire voices. Mm-hmm. If you want to learn to play an instrument too, he can teach you.
Party Pat. Let's go.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to learn how to rap too, Kenai's around every now and then, you know, sick. He's up there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's it. Yeah.
Yeah. That's pretty great. Well, lastly, Nanai and I have a few things some questions that just really keep us up at night. They're so hard for us. We don't know the answer. So we've been asking everybody who comes to help us.
Okay.
So, for a day, king for a day, will you just own all these answers and help us?
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
All right. First question.
All right. First question. Out of all the words in the English language, what word would you get rid of?
What would I get rid of?
It's gotta go. You're like, this word is not it.
Moist. Mouthfeel.
Yeah. Oh. There's not a lot of words that make me really cringeworthy or uncomfortable.
That's good.
So, man, I would say... This is a great question. Okay, give me a moment here to sit with the...
Take your time.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
You really got him thinking.
I guess out of all the words that are like, oh, gosh. I'd say like, maybe like crusty. Like crusty.
Crusty. That's a good one.
I just wasn't expecting crusty.
You know what I mean?
Usually people go for moist. Crusty.
Or if you're Raya and you're like...
Moist doesn't bother me.
Literally.
One of our students had to think on the spot and said she wants to get rid of the word scratch. And then she said, no, maybe neck. I don't know.
Scratch or neck?
That's what happens when the pressure's put on your life.
But here's the thing. But then like I think like a pizza crust is like one of the best things on the planet, so...
You say pizza crust is crusty, though?
That's a really crusty. It's more like if you have like a wound.
Yeah.
It's a crusty. Like. Oh.
No thanks.
Oh. Orifice.
Okay.
Orifices.
That's an uncomfortable word. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. What about this one? There are three.
All right.
We're not gonna say that word anymore. There are three sports in the Olympics that Nanai and I don't think deserve to be there.
Okay.
So many do. You have to be such an incredible athlete to participate. Okay. out of these three, which one would you kick to the curb? Speed walking.
Okay.
Synchronized swimming.
Okay.
Curling.
Definitely the first one. The first.
Speed walking?
Yes. I actually have a deep appreciation for curling.
Okay.
Not that I, just because. I just get mesmerized. No, when they're just like getting after it and like the thing.
It's played on the Wii.
Yeah.
It's on the Wii?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. I think there's skill.
That's how I knew what it was.
I think there's actually tremendous skill in synchronized swimming.
Yeah.
Like, dude, you're in water and your feet are like, like the same.
That's true.
Thing.
Yeah. That's true.
Like pointed toes, you know what I'm saying?
That's true.
I can't point my toes. Can you just point your toes? It's as far as I can go. Like full toe, like a full toe.
No,
point.
Well, first of all, I have braces on, so.
I feel like synchronized. I feel like synchronized. It's like you have the toe points are they're, on they're, points they're like, and they're like the same. That's amazing.
Yeah. Okay.
So speed walking.
It's gone. Yeah. Yeah. Last week or a few weeks ago, somebody said you speed walk every day.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah.
Does pineapple belong on pizza?
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely. Without a doubt.
Okay. So, we have heard it both ways.
Uh-huh.
This is a make or break point.
This
right
is
here.
A big one. when you're trying to describe the sentiment of we're gonna wait and see what happens.
Yeah.
We've heard. Play it by ear.
Uh-huh.
And play it by year. Which one is correct?
Correct?
Yeah, we've heard it both ways.
Play it by ear or play it by year?
Yeah.
Yep.
Play it by ear.
Make or break and he broke it.
Well.
What? Is it not that way?
It is, but we've just heard it play it by year, so I'm going to stick by play it by year.
We may or may not say play it by year.
That's
cool.
Gonna,
you're going to wait and see what happens over the year.
I agree with that.
Yeah.
But the phrasing is like, we're going to play it by ear, like what you hear in the moment.
Yeah, I know it's play it by ear, but I'm just sticking with play it by year because that's all I heard.
Yeah.
No, that's great.
Yeah.
Loyalty.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's great.
All right, last one. So out of all the TV shows that were made, you can either reboot one, or if it's already rebooted, which one would you get rid of?
If it's trash.
Get rid of.
If it's a reboot that was, you know, they're the ones that are garbage.
Okay.
Or a show you want to reboot.
Wait, so it can go either positive, like I want this to keep going, or total trash.
Yeah.
My goodness. Okay, I think doing a reboot, well, this isn't too new. I really enjoy Breaking Bad. Mm-hmm. That show, and I think to keep going with that would be so sick. If I'm gonna go the total trash never existed route ever, probably the thing that comes to mind is Boy Meets World. Yeah.
This wasn't that good?
Je ne sais
pas. I think it was, you know, like it came out when I was like in my, you know, angsty adolescence, trying to figure out, how to talk to girls.
Mm-hmm.
And it gave you a perception that, you know, like Corey's like the man. And he's like the super goofy doofus. And I was like, dude, it gave me hope. You know what I'm saying?
So, but it wasn't realistic.
No.
It was not.
He like dates this she's amazing. And I was like, I can be that guy. Not right then. You can't be that guy. Maybe when, you know, you're in your 20s. Awful hope for a 12-year-old experience.
Yeah, I feel that. Well, other than your unfortunate play it by ear answer.
I'm sorry.
Thank you for helping us.
Oh, yeah.
Problems.
Yeah, very much so. Yeah.
Well, we've enjoyed having you here.
Yes, thank you guys for having me. Super great.
Yeah, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe.
Smash that like button.
Smash that like button. Yeah.
Turn on your post notifications. Hit that bell in the corner.
Yep.
Comment down below your favorite part of the video. No, I'm just like.
All right. We love her anyway.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see you next time.
Peace.